Hey, what is up, everybody? Today we'll be taking a closer look at my Lego suspended train, which I designed to run on these roller coaster tracks. Now, you may be thinking, haven't I seen this before? And you would be right. I posted a build video for this model well over a year ago, and I've been meaning to put together a design video for it ever since then, but I kind of just kept putting it on the back burner. But finally, here we are. I have also posted building instructions for it over on my website. If you would like to try and build one of your own to commute around your Lego city, you can find them over at jkbrickworks.com as usual. But right now, let's take a closer look at how this works. The train is driven by the central engine units, and the other cars just freely roll along the track. For the cars, I'm using these wheel hubs because they have a relatively wide groove in the middle that fits over the rail, though I'm sure there are many other ones that would also work. Each wheel freely pivots over a pin at the top of the roof, which allows them to rotate as the cars travel around the corners. And the cars are connected using some Technic lift arms that are anchored to the same pins the wheels pivot around, so they can easily be pulled or pushed depending on which direction the train is going. Each car can also fit a couple of minifigs, which is pretty cool. And the cars at the end have a windscreen tacked on for some extra styling. I also went with my standard red and white train livery, which apparently has become a thing. The engine is the same size as the cars, which is 6 studs by 8 studs, which is pretty small and definitely too small to fit any of the current Lego standard motors and battery boxes. So for this one, I'm using Circuit Cube's components, and I was able to fit this battery and motor into a 4 by 6 stud space, which is pretty awesome. I believe they call this the Cubit motor, and I'm using the Bluetooth battery cube, which you can control using the phone app, but what I really love about it is that you can actually just turn it on as well. And it sends power to all the motors that are connected to it, which is a feature I really wish the Lego system had. The drivetrain of the engine is quite simple. I'm just routing the output of the motor up through a few gears to drive one of the wheels at the top, and the other wheel is driven via a rubber band that connects them. The wheels themselves are a combination of a standard train wheel with a white rubber band for extra grip, plus a pulley, which gives a nice sized gap to fit over the rail. My original drive wheels actually didn't use that extra white rubber band. It was a suggestion by one of my patrons after I released preliminary instructions to them last year. Without the rubber band, it still works, but the wheel pair rides up a bit when the engine is going around the corners, so it can lose some grip. And adding that little bit of extra inside diameter to the wheel helps it maintain contact with the rail. So big shout out to Eric for the great suggestion. Some people were curious how long the train would run, so I recently put it through its paces, and it ran continuously for just over an hour on a full battery charge. I'm sure some people will also ask whether it can go up any of the sloped rails, and it definitely cannot go up the steep rails. But the engine can go up and down the shallow slopes, and each car can as well individually. So I think with some modifications it could work. Right now the connection between the cars is missing a degree of freedom, so that will be something to tinker with in the future. And that is about it for this one. As I mentioned, you can find the building instructions over at jkbrickworks.com. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you in the next one.